We're back with your health matters. Recent sunshine probably has you thinking about getting outside.
That's why May is Skin Cancer Awareness Month. Here to tell us about the importance of protecting your skin is melanoma survivor Megan Rothschild. Megan, thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
So you were a very young woman, obviously. Talk about your experience in getting diagnosed so early.
Yes, I was diagnosed at the age of 20. I spotted a suspicious-looking mole on my stomach and pointed it out to my doctor, who actually advised me that it was fine. But after some pushing and some convincing, I asked to have it removed, and it was diagnosed as stage 2 melanoma.
Are there more people that are susceptible to melanoma? You know, the myth maybe is that the fair-skinned people who burn easily are the ones more susceptible to melanoma. Is that true or false?
No, it is true. There's specific factors that will contribute to your risk of melanoma. Genetics, if you have light hair, light eyes, light skin. But unfortunately, it is something that can affect every type of skin tone, every ethnicity. It just doesn't discriminate, unfortunately.
Now, at age 20, were you going in tanning beds? Were you laying out in the sun a lot?
I was doing both. I was a tanning bed user, but I also just completely stopped using sunscreen once I was able to achieve a tan through tanning booths and completely just tortured my skin over the summer months, you know, visiting the beach, going to the Cape and whatnot.
You got to put a lot of sunscreen on. Now, Dan Brown uses a lot of sunscreen. He should.
He's
fair skin. Yeah, I mean, they say duck use an entire bottle. Is that right, Megan?
It's really what it is you want to have an SPF of 30 or above, and you want to reapply every 2 hours. Even if it's waterproof, sweatproof, any of those fancy terms that they use, you want to make sure you're reapplying. And it's about a 2 ounce portion that you want to put all over your body.
Now, Megan, after you were diagnosed with stage 2 melanoma, talk about what you had to go through in terms of treatment. Was it extensive?
You know, luckily for me, because it had remained at a stage 2, I went in, I had to have a very major surgery where they did do what they call clear the margins. They cut out a huge area of skin around where the mole was located. Because of the depth of my mole, I had to have lymph nodes taken out under both arms, drainage tubes, very kind of extensive surgery. But luckily for me, my lymph nodes came back clear, which means the cancer had not spread inside my body. So I didn't have to take the next step, which would have been an interferon or chemotherapy.
How do you tell the difference between moles or growths that are harmless to those that might be cancerous?
Well, there's warning signs called the ABCDEs of melanoma, asymmetrical, border, color, diameter, and evolution. However, what I always recommend to people is you really should be seeing a dermatologist once a year. They're the experts. They're the folks that can track what's going on your skin. That way you don't have to ultimately be responsible to figure out what moles might be questionable and what might not. Just leave that up to the experts.
Heading into Memorial Day weekend Monday, it's supposed to be beautiful. What would you recommend in terms of time exposure outdoors? Should you cover yourself, head inside, run inside and protect yourself at moments?
Yeah, we're not. I don't encourage people, I don't tell people they can't go outside. You still have to be able to go to the beach. You have to go and enjoy yourself. It's just being smart about it, making sure that you're not laying out there in direct sunlight for, you know, hours on end, wearing your SPF, maybe wear a hat, sunglasses. You can get melanomas on the scalp or in the eyes. So it's really just everything in moderation. Make sure you're careful about your exposure.
Megan, thank you so much. We appreciate it. It's very good advice for folks, especially with the weekend coming up. So we appreciate you telling your story.
Thank you for having me.